Hello mga ka-Arki! Welcome to this special video series of Wealth Arki entitled Global Investing for the Filipino Investor, which is done in partnership with AXA Philippines. Kasama natin dito sa video series na to si Mr. Dexter Agkawili, who is the Investment Solutions Director of AXA Philippines and the country representative to Arkitas Asia, an asset management company of the AXA Group. Check out the video description for the links to all the 5 episodes of this video series. That's it for my intro. Let's begin. Hello mga ka-Arki and welcome sa episode 2 nito ating special video series. And of course, kasama pa rin natin si Sir Dexter. Kamusta Dex?
Hello! Hi Fritz! Hi Renzi! Hello mga ka-Arki! Ito, doing well kahit nandito sa bahay.
Ay! Oo nga!
Ganda ng bahay mo ha!
Ang ganda kasi ng green screen mo.
Ang ganda ng bahay mo, ha?
Huli.
So, of course, nandito na naman tayo sa ating special video series discussing yes. about global investing for the Filipino investor in partnership with AXA Philippines. And kung hindi nyo pa napapanood yung episode 1, dapat panoorin nyo muna. But in summary, we discussed dun sa episode 1 na yung barriers sa pag-i-invest sa global markets ay mas mababa na ngayon, mas madali na, mas accessible. And dapat we make it part of our investment or financial plan yung i-check out yung mga opportunities na ino-offer sa global markets.
Sabi nga natin, there's a bigger world out there. Goodbye pond, which is the Philippine
Hello,
target.
Ocean.
Hello ocean. Yeah. Yeah. Marami yeah. marami as in super bubukas ang mundo ninyo kapag tinignan ninyo at nakita ang mga opportunities dito sa global investing.
So, yung mga nailista ko na mga benefits pagdating sa pag-i-invest in the global markets are diversification, investment growth, wide range of investment options, asset allocation, it broadens our investing experience, and it boosts our portfolio quality, which is what I plan to ask sa inyong dalawa, no? And let's start with yung benefit of diversification. Can you explain more yung benefit na yon, Dexter?
Thank you, Fitz. Actually, may natutunan nga ako dun sa isang Facebook post ng isang kaibigan natin dyan, eh, no? Diversify. Nilike ko nga, eh. Yung, yung global diversification, dahil nga, kahit minsan, kahit diversified ka na, dito sa Philippines, meron ka ng bonds, stocks, and kung ano-ano pa. Pero di natin naiisip, if everything is in the Philippines, ang tawag natin doon is country risk. So, may mangyari doon sa isang country, kung hindi gumagalaw yung stock market for the past 5 years, katulad ng experience natin in the past 5 years, pag-gilid-gilid lang, edi, paano na mag-grow yung investment mo? No? So, we have to manage country risk. So, global diversification is managing the risk na concentrated ka lang sa isang country or isang economy. And kapag invested ka in a different parts of the world, different parts of different kinds of economies, kumbaga, one, nakakahanap ka ng better opportunities outside. And also, at the same time, na minimize mo yung exposure mo sa isang country lang. And also, kahit sabihin natin nung at the height ng sell-off mga March last year.
Diba? March.
Philippine equities, I think, bumaba na mga 40%. Di ba? In a couple of days or weeks.
Yeah. Mga
40%, di ba? Tapos, ibang markets naman, bumaba rin, pero hindi naman ganun kalala. Mga tipong 15%, not as much. So, on managing your risk, hindi tipong hindi ka makakita ng negative 40%, but rather pwedeng less negative yung ano portfolio mo. That's at least on the context of managing your risk, di ba?
Right. Tapos parang dagdag ko lang din, di ba, Dex, pag dito sa Philippines, no, pag mag-invest ka sa stock market, di ba, you also look into yung mga blue chips, di ba, mga second liners, mga third liners, kumbaga yung mga super big companies, tapos yung mga not so big, tapos yung mga speculative companies. But in pero Dex, di ba, in the global realm of things, how would the largest companies in the Philippines fare with global companies?
Wow.
Super lit, di ba?
Super lit.
Pag ilang liner tayo kaya pag sa global?
Sipin mo na lang, pare. Yung
pinakamalaki.
Magkano value traded natin in a day sa Philippine Stock Exchange? Mga 10 billion pesos.
10 billion.
Magkano
buong stock market na yan. Buong stock market na yan.
Tapos, tignan mong trading ng ano, the likes of Microsoft lang, kahit Microsoft na ano, na stock, isang stock, in hundreds of millions of dollars in one day.
Dollars pa. One day pa yun.
Punto ko dun is that ano eh, ganong kalaki yung market out there na kung kukumpara mo yung Philippine market, wala pang ano eh, hindi pa katumbas ng isang stock ng ano ng isang big global company, di ba?
So kumbaga Dex, ano no, parang yung mga blue chips natin, yung mga super tiwala tayo mga blue chips. Pagdating pag tinabi no sa global company, sa global market, and dahil pinag-usapan natin yung diversification, parang biglang super you're really riding with the lumiliit, saka parang you're already ano no, you're standing on the shoulders of giants, kumbaga, di ba? When you correct. Invest in the global markets and in the global funds, tama?
Correct. Ang advantage nga niyan is, as you go global, you can also get to have access to global asset managers then.
So, when it comes to diversification, syempre napaka-obvious na if you invest in global funds, you are having access do sa mga iba't ibang klaseng companies, especially yung mga big companies in other markets like in the US or in Europe. And then, because of that, you have the potential to make money dun sa growth ng mga ibang economies. Katulad ng pandemic, syempre, meron tayong bias towards mga tech companies kasi sila talaga yung magti-take off pagdating sa economy na kailangan nasa bahay ka lang, no? So syempre there was an uptick pagdating sa tech companies. Eh kung nasa Pilipinas ka lang, wala naman talaga tayong global giant dito na tech company na iwanan ka. So mas maganda talaga na meron kang access sa mga global economies global funds, so that your portfolio will have the opportunity to grow and you have a wider range of investment options kapag meron kang access sa global market. But dun sa nabanggit mo kanina, Renzi, it also made me wonder na yung diversification, it's not just about yung assets. Kasi sabi mo, meron ka rin access sa mga asset managers na siyempre iba yung skill set, probably mas magaling, mas matagal yung experience kasi masanay din sila sa mga mas complicated na market, which I think is very good, no? Kasi hindi ka lang nakasalalay sa mga local fund managers, but if you invest in a global fund, you are also diversifying doon sa talent na available sa mga ibang mga funds. Tama, no?
That's right, no? Parang naka-outsource ka. Marami kang mga outsourced. Outsourced na yung itong portfolio ko sa itong fund manager. Tapos itong fund manager na to is good in this particular, sabi natin, sector or sabi natin region. Then, you know, you get to outsource them as well. Pero may tanong kay Dexter, since napag-uusapan na yung diversification, magkano ba kitaan dyan? Kasi diversified ka nga. Baka mamaya, ang na-diversify mo is yung loss yung na-diversify. So, magkano bang kitaan natin dyan sa mga global funds na yan? Like,
Magandang reference mo kanina is ano, how 2020 was, di ba?
Yes.
While the Philippines is like down 8%, global investments are actually up. One good example is, say, the likes of if you're invested in the US market, depending kung anong mark o anong particular exposure mo. Pero for example, technology was like giving 40% returns in 2020. Mainly because sila yung focus. Dahil nasa bahay ka, ano bang ginagawa mo? Netflix. Or ano bang ginagawa mo? Amazon ka.
Facebook.
Okay, Facebook ka, di ba? Pero point ko is that yung may mga certain sectors globally is actually a good opportunity, giving you good opportunity because siling nandun sa growth phase, no? So it can really vary, and we did some ano, some backtesting rin nga dyan eh, na yung benefit kasi of diversifying is that while say the local market is not doing well, there is one way or another certain economy or group of economies out there na doing better. Dahil one good example, pagkatapos ng pandemic, ano ba yung mga unang most likely maunang mag-recover? Ito yung mga marami nang na-vaccinate, tapos ano,
consumer mga ganyan.
So the likes of US, China, pero you get to participate in the upside of those kinds of economies. So yung mga developed markets and pwedeng maka-recover faster than emerging markets. So in globally diversifying, us coming from the Philippines na nasa emerging market, we have that opportunity to also invest and take the upside of global markets and developed markets.
I was looking at your at your different funds, AXA, but I'm quite impressed, ha? And
at chinecot muna kami.
Siyempre, due diligence natin 'yan. I'm quite impressed, ha? And I'm really not impressed as much with other funds, pero I'm impressed yung global. I'm looking at the peso, no? I think these are the peso ones or the dollar, but your Global Advantage Fund gave 40%. Ito lahat to for the year 2020, no? Yung Global Advantage Fund gave 40%.
Yes, that is yung dollar. Yeah, 40%.
Oh, the dollar. Yeah, I think, yeah, mga dollar to. But nonetheless, no? I mean, maski i-convert mo sa peso, kaunti lang naman. The Global Advantage gave 40%. Wow. Yep. The Dynamic Allocation Growth gave 17.8%. And then the Dynamic Allocation Multi-Asset gave 13%. Wow, galing ah! So imagine natin mga ka-Arki, no, if you are not invested, sabihin mo na lang tong Global Advantage Fund ni AXA na 40%. If you are not invested in this one, then you're missing out 40%. Sayang yun. Malaki rin yung 40%. Hindi ka makakatisod ng ganito ngayon.
Pero may tanong ako, pag nag-invest ka ba globally, automatic high risk yon? Meron bang mga global investment na low risk or moderate risk lang? Kasi kunwari ako, gusto ko mag-invest globally. Pero ayoko naman yung masyadong volatile. May mga ganun ba?
Yeah. Good question, Fitz. No? Kasi unang-unang pumapasok sa isip ng mga tao is that, ay, kung mag-invest ako globally, ma-expose ako sa FX risk, may expose ako sa exchange rate ng dollar peso, di ba? Pero ang dapat nating unawain is ano bang konteksto natin sa matayo nagagaling? Nagagaling tayo sa Philippines na nasanay lang tayo pero malikot ang market natin. Okay? Kumbaga, from a high risk market, kung magda-diversify ka to let's say the likes of Hong Kong, Singapore, China or Korea, lesser risk markets yun, di ba? Tapos, kahit sabihin natin, okay, yung galaw ng exchange rate natin, may plus minus ka yan, pero isipin mo naman, kung nandito ka lang, down ka ng 8-12%, talagang, down na yun. As compared to, kung sabihin natin, yung other markets grew by 8%, tapos exchange rate, medyo nalugi ka ng 1%, still, 7%, it's still a better, you know, better experience. Now, so that's one. Next, to your point on the exchange, on the paano yung mga different kinds of risks, so to speak. So, gaya ng ano ng when we look at meron kang fixed income, meron kang balance fund, may equity fund ka here in the Philippines from low risk to high risk. There are also such global funds available na if you're relatively conservative, you can have more of the fixed income, global fixed income na hindi lang Philippine credits, credit rating ang exposure mo, but rather other na in other investment grade, may it be Asian or even US or European. It's a choice. Pero point dun is, there is that diversified fixed income portfolio that you can readily take advantage of. Yun. And then, pwede ka rin, you can create a balanced portfolio as well, a fixed income and an equity portfolio combined. Yun. And then, ano naman, kung gusto mong maging, ano, mas maging aggressive, global equities. Tapos, kung meron kang conviction, pwede kang mag-choose ng particular region, pwede rin. Diba? Pero as you concentrate it from, let's say, a global standpoint to a more regional, doon mo makikita na, syempre, tataas yung risk mo dahil mas nagiging concentrated ka na naman sa isang lugar. Eh.
So, pwede pala, no? May conservative option. But next, curious question. For your fixed income portfolio, do you have like a minimum rating for the funds or for the, you know, for the direct securities, if ever, for your fixed income?
Okay, so for our, we do have our fixed income na na ROP, okay? Tapos meron din kami yung global na global fixed income. Our global fixed income on average would be maintained as an investment grade.
Investment grade.
Yeah, on average yan. So, while meron mga high yield pero meron ding mga ano talaga high grade kung tawagin across the world, on average it is an investment grade rating.
Okay, so kumbaga no, so sa mga karki natin that are medyo hindi pa sanay sa offshore or global investing, pagdating sa fixed income yon, at least on the average investment grade naman yung pinupuntahan ng ano, hindi yung mga junk bonds, di ba? So you're assured that ano, quality ang laman ng mga funds natin.
All right. So to repeat no, yung mga benefits when you invest in the global markets, of course may diversification ka, meron kang opportunities for investment growth, and there's a wide range of investment options. Of course kasi buong mundo yung market mo, and it's also a way for you to do some diversification when it comes to asset allocation. And dahil naglalagay ka na ng pera in other markets, it also encourages you to broaden your investing experience, no? Hindi lang local business and finance news ang binabasa mo, malamang nagbabasa ka na rin ng mga global news. Nasa Bloomberg ka na or
hindi ka na, no? Hindi ka na nasa hindi ka na nasa comics saka showbiz section.
Oo.
Philippine market, kung sabi nga ni Dex kanina, no, Philippine market kung masyadong malalim yung down, pero yung iba hindi masyadong malalim. So nahihila niya, na-offset niya 'yon. So it improves then the quality of your portfolio in that regard.
So kung ako convinced na ako na sige, I have a portion of my investment fund put in a global fund, or I want to put it in the international markets, what are some of the things that they should keep in mind? Ano ba yung mga kailangan malaman nila? What is the proper way to start on investing in the global market? Ano ba yung mga ako, initial steps natin?
Yeah. Sasagot muna ako, Dexter, ha?
Go.
Kasi for me lang, ha, number one sa akin, dapat kilala mo yung pag-iinvestan mo. Number one. Sa, kasi we're talking of offshore na eh. So, pag local kasi, you know, the usual suspects, di ba? You have banks, you have asset management companies, you have trust institutions, usual suspect. Yes. But offshore global markets is really parang, ano ba? Parang uncharted territory. So, if it's an uncharted territory at nilalabas na yung pera mo, then you really have to deal with an institution na may track record sa kilala mo. Kasi kung offshore yan at tinakbo yung pera mo, eh kung hindi covered ng BSP yan or hindi covered ng insurance commission yan or any other regulator, then say goodbye to your money. Diba? Kasi these are essentially not under, you know, some of them might not actually be under the the regulation or supervision of the Philippine government.
So, tama naman talaga yun. No? So, one is the reputation, knowing that institution that you're dealing with is very important, lalo na rampant yung marami kang na babalitaan the past few years or even months about yung mga scams that's happening out there, di ba? Lalo na. So, that's one. And also, as you also get to, nilimit mo na to reputable institutions, for example. Worth also asking, ano ba yung fund that you're investing in? Dahil minsan, sinasabi, this is already an offshore fund. Pero alamin mo, research about it, read about it. Again, there's what we call global funds na tipong more than just one region yung ininvestan yan. Right? Tapos meron yung regional funds na tipong sa isang Asian ba yan or European ang ininvestan or meron bang particular sector na ininvestan. May mga ganung bagay na tipong technology fund. And ngayon nga, may mga interesting funds na lumalabas na okay yung naging performance is mga responsible investing fund, yung mga ESG, di ba? Oh, may mga ganyan. So that's another trend na emerging. So pero point ko doon is arali natin. Kumbaga, research on it, read about it, ask don't hesitate on asking the person offering you, ano ba yung objective ng fund na yan? Ano ba yung mga risks, di ba?
Ang naintindihan ko, unang-una, kung gusto mong mag-invest in the global market, meron kang first option is maghanap ka ng company abroad, mag-open ka ng account doon, and then magkakapag-invest ka na, no? But of course, merong risk yon kasi you're sending your money abroad, tapos you're not directly interacting with an entity na na-check ng Philippine government. Meaning, kapag tinakbo yung pera susugurin. Mo...
Wala ka susugurin.
The second option, which I think is better, is you find a company in the Philippines na sila yung tutulong sa'yo na mag-invest in the global market. So, kumbaga, mag-open ka ng account locally. So you're dealing with a Philippine entity, Pinoy yung kausap mo, and then sila yung company na either meron silang partners abroad na dun sila nag-i-invest, or sila mismo, like AXA Philippines, di ba, merong AXA Asset Management Company, ang AXA Group, yung anong name nun?
We have Arkitas. Arkitas is our... multi-manager na asset management firm. Tapos we also have AXA IM or AXA Investment Managers.
Oo. So kung nag-invest ako, for example, sa AXA, syempre, AXA Philippines ang kausap ko, Pinoy yung kausap ko, sa inyo ko binibigay yung pera ko. Pero, meron kayong international na asset management or global asset management company yun ngayon yung nag-i-invest, nag-a-analyze ng markets para mapalago yung pera ko. So, I think that is the better or safer option sa akin. Of course, may mga tao, malalakas ang loob, gusto dumiretso. Pero meron akong ikikwento sa inyo. Last year, nung nagka-pandemic, a lot of people predicted na tataas nga yung mga tech companies. And yung mga kakilala ko na merong access sa US market, may mga foreign broker sila, nagbibili ng stocks ng Zoom. Pero, problema, ang Zoom na binili nila ay yung Zoom technologies. Mali. Mm. That's Daling a penny Zoom. Stock in the US market. Kasi ang stock code ng Zoom ay ZOOM. So akala ng tao yun yung Zoom company. Pero in fact, ang stock code nung Zoom na ginagamit natin sa mga online conference natin ay ZN. So so mali talaga, nagkaroon pa ng ano eh. Alam ko nagkaroon ng stock holding na pinatigil yung trading ng Zoom Technologies kasi penny stock yon, so mali. The right symbol talaga is yung Zoom Video Communications, which is yung ZN. So that's one of the risk that you have kung ikaw mismo yung nag-invest directly. But of course, kung wala ka talagang time na pag-aralan yung mga intricate details of the global markets, you can always put your money in a global fund, work with a financial institution that can offer you global funds so that you can take advantage of the growth in other markets without having that risk na magkamali ka ng pipiliin, no? But of course, it's always important to first understand kung ano ba yung pinapasok mo. You have to, in general, you have to understand how the global markets interact with each other, di ba? Ano ba yung relationship nitong mga global markets na to? Minsan, hindi natin iniisip eh. Basta lagay lang tayo ng lagay ng pera. And parang ano yan eh, parang binabaril mo lang yung target mo pero hindi ka marunong umasinta. Kasi hindi mo alam, di ba? So, yun yung nakita kong very important, or I think the most important thing to keep in mind if you want to invest in the global markets. Being able to understand ano yung pinapasok mo and being able to find a person or an institution na you are willing to work with. And of course, kung katulad ng AXA Philippines, you have local representatives or ang tawag nga nila, di ba, AXA Financial Partners,
financial advisors.
Or financial advisors that they can talk to if they want to learn more about how they can access itong mga global funds na to.
If I may add, I think one important thing that we should also bear in mind as we start opening our eyes, going beyond our shores in doing investing, is that we take those steps correctly. Kahit small steps lang eh. Meaning, kahit mag-funds ka muna eh, di ba? Investment funds to diversify your portfolio. Malaking bagay na yun eh. Hindi mo kinakailangan mag-stock pick kagad eh. Pero as you increase your investment literacy, financial literacy, start investing, diversify your portfolio, kahit funds lang yan, diversified na. And then, as you build your confidence, dun ka na maging innovative, slowly but surely. But what is important is we take those steps gradually, at least we start moving forward. One last. Kasi na-highlight ni Renzi one good point about yung mga clients niya. Mostly, clients niya are institutional clients, right? Now, ako, when I was handling clients also years back, most of institutional clients lang yung mga kayang mag-invest globally. Kaya sila yung nakakatikot.
They have the volume and, They have the volume.
And also, mga high net worth clients, yung mga nakaka-diversify lang globally. But now, in recent years, with all these global funds being made available through affordable unit investment trust funds, mutual funds, or variable linked products, the common Filipino can now also diversify their portfolio. So it's really worth looking into.
So that's a very good point. And as we mentioned no, nung episode 1, na yung access natin sa pag-invest sa global markets mas dumadali, unlike in previous years or unlike in the past 30, 20 years. Mas madali na ngayon. And as we've talked today, there are a lot of advantages, there are a lot of benefits in investing in global funds. And siyempre, kung naghahanap tayo ng financial institution where we can invest in the international markets, nandito ang AXA Philippines na available sa inyo para tulungan kayo na iplano ang inyong investment journey. So, as we are showing to you on screen, you can talk to an AXA financial partner today by going to axa.com.ph/appointments, or you can just scan the QR code that you're seeing right now dito sa ating screen. Alright. So, katulad ng ayan, katulad ng nabanggit ni Dexter, ang AXA Philippines, marami silang mga global funds na available. Mayroong mga low risk, may moderate risk, high risk. Mayroong dynamic allocation fund. May mga funds na nag-i-invest sa tech, na nag-i-invest sa European market, etc. So, ang dami niyan. Alin dyan yung pipiliin mo? And that will be our topic for episode 3. So, I hope they stay
para
tuned.
Star Wars lang, ha? Para
yes,
Star Wars lang, ha?
Yes, episode 3 na tayo. Alright. So, maraming salamat mga ka-Arki sa panonood itong episode 2.
Thank you.
Kita-kita ulit tayo sa next episode natin. And salamat Dexter, salamat Tracy.
Thank you
for having me.
Yeah, so second, see you again sa next episode natin next week. Alright, so bye-bye.
Thanks, Dex. Bye.
Mga ka-Arki, as we learned, global investing may just be the key to reaching your financial goals. But remember to study your options first and work with a trusted financial institution. Reach out to an AXA financial partner today and we will help you create your global investing game plan.